Welcome folks, in this presentation we will be reviewing polymorphism. Crystal structure cannot be determined exclusively by chemical composition, for example carbon. It exists in the form of graphite and diamond. Both of them have greatly different structures yet the same chemical formula of C. Also, minerals related by chemical composition have great importance in mineralogy. Changes in the crystal structure not only changes the mineral identity but also changes many of its physical and chemical properties. It is important to think why a chemical composition can exist in more than one form and also that how it makes them different minerals. Remember that in the definition of a mineral, the substance must have a fixed chemical composition for it to be a mineral. That is why we study polymorphism in minerals. The phenomenon of occurrence of an element or compound in more than one crystallographic structure is called polymorphism. We just saw an example, graphite and diamond, which are polymorphs of carbon. The minerals showing polymorphism are called polymorphs, and each polymorph has its own physical properties and a distinct arrangement of its atoms. What causes the difference in the structures of polymorphs is the difference in the temperature and pressure of the environment in which the polymorphs are forming. This is evident from these pressure-temperature graphs of carbon and CaCO3. As they are formed under different conditions, the resulting structures are not the same. These polymorphs can be classified according to the number of distinct crystalline forms it may have. When a mineral exists in two different crystalline structures, then this phenomenon is called dimorphism. Carbon shows dimorphism. Diamond achieves its exceptionally close-knit and strongly bonded structure of highly directive covalent bonds due to the extreme pressure condition in which it forms. Among the dimorphs of FeF2, pyrite has cubic crystal system, whereas the other polymorph, marcasite, forms in orthorhombic system. Aragonite forms in higher pressure than calcite. In calcite, calcium is in 6-fold coordination with the oxygen, which means each calcium atom is surrounded by 6 oxygen atoms. However, in aragonite, calcium is in 9-fold coordination with oxygen, which needs higher pressure conditions to form. The dimorph of KalSi3O8, cyanidine and microcline have monoclinic and triclinic crystal system respectively, and cyanidine is the higher temperature variety, which is quickly cooled from the high temperature of eruption. Similarly, when a mineral shows three distinct structures, the phenomenon is called trimorphism. Examples of trimorphs include TiO2, which may exist as rutile, anatase or brookite. Three different structural arrangements of Al2O3SiO2 are andalusite, kyanite and sillimanite. All these minerals can be found in metamorphic rocks of all geological ages. It is to be noted that polymorphism is not limited to dimorphism and trimorphism. There are 9 well-known polymorphs of quartz, namely strixivite, coesite, low quartz, high quartz, low tridymite, high tridymite, low cristobalite, high cristobalite, and kaolite. Out of these, kaolite is made synthetically and is not found in nature. Structure of quartz represents the three-dimensional tectosilicate structure, and these polymorphs indicate that the three-dimensional structure can exist in 9 different ways. Though quartz is chemically simple, but its behavior in the PT graph is quite complex. Low quartz is found in all types of rocks, signifying its formation at relatively low temperature and pressures. Coesite is a high-pressure form of silica and is thus found in meteorite impact craters. It may also sometimes occur inside inclusions of diamonds and garnets formed under very high-pressure conditions. We have seen that two polymorphs have same chemical composition but different structural properties. There also exist minerals like pyrite and limonite where the chemical composition is different yet the external form is the same. This is known as pseudomorphism. It is the process of replacement in which a mineral retains its outward crystal form of another species. This name comes from a Greek word which means false form, and this aptly describes this process. So, in pseudomorphs, the chemical composition and structure belongs to one mineral species, whereas crystal form belongs to another. When pyrite changes to limonite, the resulting pseudomorph is called a pseudomorph of limonite after pyrite. It can be seen that the external cubic feature has been preserved during the process of pseudomorphism. Now, pseudomorphs are usually defined according to the manner in which they are formed, which causes them to be classified as substitution, incrustation, and alteration. Substitution is that type of pseudomorphism in which there is removal of the original material and a simultaneous replacement of it by another material with no chemical reaction occurring between the two. A common example of substitution is wood opal or silicified wood, in which each carbon atom of the wood's molecule is replaced by silica. Fossilized pine cones and replacement of a snail shell with emerald are also examples of substitution. Incrustation occurs when the crust of one mineral is deposited over the crystals of another. Often, the substrate over which the mineral originally grew is completely dissolved and removed. This image shows the pseudomorph of quartz after fluoride. Numerous small crystals have completely encrusted the chloride crystal, preserving the cube structure. Alteration is that type of pseudomorphism where a gradual chemical change alters the composition of a mineral but allows it to retain its old form. Alteration pseudomorphism is shown by anhydride CaSO4 which gradually changes to gypsum. Galena changing to anglesite is another example. Often in alteration, the core of the original mineral may be found inside the pseudomorph. That's all for this presentation. Thank you.